Sally, we're here at the launch for the London Film Festival. You've got your film here this year. Tell me all about it.
My film, My Brother the Devil, is in competition. I'm really excited because it's the UK premiere and also it's a London movie. It was the whole film is set in Hackney. A lot of the cast come from kind of London, a young cast. So for it to come home to London Film Festival and for the premiere to be here is just wonderful news. It's exciting for the whole cast and crew who worked really hard.
Tell me a bit about the inspiration behind the film.
There isn't one place that it comes from. I've lived in Hackney for over 10 years, so that's why it's set there, I guess. The main characters are British Egyptian brothers, teenage boys. I'm half Egyptian, so I certainly like drew upon my own kind of background in terms of like that culturally specific viewpoint. But really, it's a multicultural film. There are kids, you know, from Somalia, Nigeria, you know, all different colours and creeds. The way London really is.
And tell me about the young guys who are the stars of it as well, because they are phenomenal, aren't they?
Fadi El Sayed, who plays Mo, the little brother, it's actually his first film, and he lives not far from where we shot the film, so he is Egyptian as well. He's incredible. He was so dedicated to the film. Actually, it was his 18th birthday when we were shooting, and he didn't celebrate. He put his whole birthday on hold until we'd finished filming. That's how seriously he took it, which was amazing. And James Floyd, who's a kind of rising star, I guess, he plays Rashid, the big, like Mo's big brother. And he went very method because his background isn't very like street. So he kind of got to know a lot of the guys that I knew. And he spent 5 months kind of going undercover really going about the whole preparation in a very method way. And learning everything like that, hanging out with Eamon a lot.
So how did that help you as a director? Because it's your first film as a director, you've written it as well. It's quite a big task to take on, isn't it?
Yeah, well, I guess so. I mean, for me, this film's, when you make a film, it's such a part of you after 5 years of kind of half a decade, really, of dedicating your life to like one project. You better kind of approach it with the mentality that if you only have one film to make before you die, what's that film going to be? So that's certainly kind of the mentality that I approached it with.
Now, it's a film that is quite different to other films on kind of similar subjects. How did you make the kind of decisions behind the characters you have in there and the journey they go on?
It was a very organic process. I mean, the film took 5 years to make, and for many years of that 5 years, I was developing the script. I got to know a lot of boys who were involved in gangs in different areas of London and did a lot of research with them. Eamon Hamducci, who plays Repo in the film, he was my script consultant and one of my key people when I was kind of doing all my research. And I just started hanging around lots of 16, 17-year-old boys for many years. And you know, when I was spending all this time with them, I saw how much pressure there was that they were putting on themselves to be men, and there was all this kind of machismo going on. So I kind of wanted to explore that in terms of the story and the movie.
And tell me about getting the language right, because as you say, it's very specific, isn't it, to an age group as well?
Yeah, well, as you can probably hear and see, I don't speak, urban London, but I certainly learnt the language, and it was like learning a foreign language. And by, you know, later kind of drafts, I'd share what I'd written with the script consultant, and he's like, God, you don't need me anymore. You're getting it all right.
And what are you up to next, Sally?
I'm writing. So I'm writing a few scripts at the moment for other films. One's a London film. That's the one that I'm mainly most like passionate about at the moment.
And what can we kind of look forward to in terms of maybe the genre or the feel, the style of them?
It's different to My Brother the Devil. I think I need a change. So almost like a response from My Brother the Devil. It's a completely different world, but it is a world in that same way that My Brother the Devil is a very specific and authentic world. So is this next one, but a different world.